If you're afraid of coming down and going and swimming in the ocean because of sharks, you should be terrified to make a piece of toast. 400 people died last year from defective toasters, whereas less than 10 did from sharks. This is the first large shark expedition like this in the Western Gulf. We'll be tagging hammerhead sharks, tiger sharks, and mako sharks, trying to understand how they're leveraging the Gulf in their birthing, mating, and full migratory patterns. We'll be getting up every day just before dawn. The fishing team will be going out, getting all of our lines rigged and ready to go. And then we'll get the ship in position with a lift in the water. And we'll be looking to capture, bring sharks back to the lift, lift them up out of the water. And once we do that, a whole team of scientists from a half dozen institutions will circle around the shark. And we'll conduct 12 research projects in about 15 minutes, then release the shark and open source the tracking to the world so that everyone can follow it. What we're finding is that these massive sharks have huge, huge movements across the ocean. We have one of these white sharks, Lydia, who's traveled over 35,000 miles in just 2 years. Very, very regular for these sharks to be swimming 1,000 miles a month, which is why it's so important to figure out where they go. We're losing 200,000 sharks a day for shark fin soup, 100 million a year. You know, people need to understand, an ocean with no sharks means an ocean with no fish. They are the lion, the balance keeper of the ocean. And if they are not there, the whole food chain collapses. This is a simple battle. We gotta solve the puzzle of these sharks' lives to make sure they flourish and make a difference for the future.